Good morning. Day 89 in our series 2 to 5. Let me adjust this because I can't hear how loud I'm talking. 89. This morning, I am working on a scene that I worked on yesterday. And this was one where there was a lot of blowout from a window, like kind of pouring into a window, and I'm trying to sort of take the edge off of that. Like I had said yesterday, you can't like completely fix it, just because like you can dial down the brightness, but typically when you're dialing down the brightness, you're trying to highlight whatever's sort of underneath it, so it gives a little bit more of the detail of what's underneath it. With this particular scenes and those that are similar to it, there's nothing underneath it. I mean, it's just pure white. So you can dial it down, but there's not going to be any detail in there. So basically I'm just trying to take sort of the edge off of it. And I've done that for several shots in here. It's actually been really, really good just in terms of locking down a routine. It's not something that makes a huge difference, but it's helped me to understand the whole keyframing process, because if there's movement within the scene, I'm having to, you know, basically draw these shapes, and as the characters move or as the camera moves, I'm trying to keep the shape in that one particular area that needs correcting. So it's helping me lock in that process. Like I said, even though it's not making a huge difference in terms of, you know, aesthetics. So kind of twofold. It's fixing it a little bit, but also educating me at the same time. Also, that whole neat video denoising thing. So I got through all of this piece of kind of dialing down the window, and I'm like, well, I wonder if the denoising will work on this. I wonder how much noise there is. And there's not a ton, but there's enough to where it does make a difference. So again, I'm going through it and denoising this as well. And which helps to actually bring out some of the, because like all the brightness from the window puts light on their faces. Which just sort of blows them out a little bit. So when you can take the noise down, it just gives a little bit more of the detail on their faces. So it's helping. But again, it takes a while to do these and to get them rendered. So that's probably what I'm going to work on this morning before I bounce over to doing some writing. I don't know if I'll get all of these rendered this morning, but I don't know. It's looking good, man. I'm really excited about how it's turning out now that we've got the basics in there and the rough assembly done. Now we're just sort of having a layer of sharpening the edges, if you will. So looks good, man. Good. All right. Well, as has been rather common lately, I've punted, and I just wanted to fix one more thing with the editing, and that pretty much took up the rest of my time, and I didn't get it fixed. So basically what I did was I was doing the whole denoising thing, and I'm like, well, I'll finish that up later because I know what I'm doing with that. But this particular scene also had the actors. We were in this attic, basically, and it was super hot, and the actors, they have sweat on their faces, and I'm like, well, maybe I can clean that up, you know, maybe take the sweat off their face. So I tried one particular effect where basically you take a copy of the current clip and put it on top, and then change the, like, give it like a blur. And I was hoping that would sort of take the shine off of their face, but this tip basically put a blur on the entire screen, so it didn't work. So there was another suggestion out there to add this plugin called Beauty Box, which basically does an algorithm and it studies the clip and determines the various skin tone ranges. And once it does that, then you can adjust that. So I was messing around with that, but apparently this thing is a resource hog, because when I tried to apply this effect, I got it installed. It was free. I got it installed and dragged it on top of the clip, and immediately the system just starts bogging down. It restarted, or it actually shut down Final Cut Pro, and I restarted it again. Then when I restarted it, it took forever, like 10 or 15 minutes to come back up, and I'm like, ugh, this is not good. So basically, once it got back up and running, I took the effect off, and I did a little bit more research, and apparently that is one of the issues that it does have with it, is that it does use a lot of resources. And they basically say wait till the very end to apply it and do your corrections on that, and then don't try and do it while you're editing these things. So I have it there. I might try it later on to see if it works, but I'm going to try a few other things with the sweat drips and see if I can get that taken care of. So so that's basically it this morning. This process of like learning as you go is cool in a way, because I mean I'm constantly picking up things, but sometimes it just slows me down. I don't feel like I got that much done, but I was able to finish the one scene, and take those, deal with that whole window thing. I did get some denoising done on that one, so this one's actually looking really nice. I was a little nervous about it because it was that window really sort of blew things out, but I think we've taken enough of the edge off of that to where it looks decent, and also fits sort of the aesthetic of the scene too, because you have basically a pastor that's going into a room and gambling and playing poker with his buddies. So he's on one side, you got the light pouring in the window behind him, and then you flip the camera back around and one of his buddies, who's not a bad guy at all, but he has like this black shirt on, so it's the contrast between the two actually works for the scene. I wish I could say that I planned that out. I mean, I could say it, but it would be a total lie, because I didn't. It just so happened to work out like that. So I like those little happy accidents. But even with that, we still needed to take and deal with that window, because it was too distracting. I've noticed, even with the beads of sweat, like it's not a huge deal, but it takes so much work to like get a viewer into the story that any little thing that is a distraction, like I don't want them looking at the sweat on their face, because it'd be like, God, why is it, why don't they have the air conditioning on, why is it so hot there? And immediately when you do that, you take them out of the story. So it's just something you have to keep in mind. You want to keep them locked in. Once you get them in there, you want to keep them locked in so that they, keep that suspension of disbelief and, get them in that world and have them stay there. So anyway, that's it for today. Tomorrow, much of the same, man. We're going to be hammering away at the denoising, hopefully finish up that particular piece with this scene, and then start moving forward and making some more progress, and then hopefully do some writing. Jeez, I do it during the day, but man, these morning sessions, the editing is just eating up all my time. But all good, man. We're getting there. So tomorrow too.